So you see the title of the video and you know exactly what's going to happen. So we're not going to even waste any time. We're going to jump right into what these five things are right now. So hi everybody, my name is Luke Smith. If this is your first time on the channel, welcome. If you are returning, welcome back. Thanks for being a part of the family. Just a bit of context, because it's important for us to define our terms. So what I mean when I say adulting, I mean you are somewhat responsible for yourself. It doesn't necessarily have anything to do with age, but you're at a place where you are pretty much responsible for yourself in some way, whether it be financially or you're living in your own space, preferably if you're living in your own space in one way or the other. So the first one is adulting is fun.
What?
Yes, I'm serious. So with most things, you know, people tend to focus on the negatives and on the challenges, but adulting is actually fun. There is nothing like coming home from a long, difficult day and having your own space that you can unwind, you can play some Xbox, you can watch a movie, or just be in your own space. There's nothing to compare that to. I wouldn't trade that for anything. And I know many of us are in our early stages. We want to find ways how to save and how to cut back costs. And so a lot of times that may require us to live with either family for an extended period or to be roommates with other people so that you can afford the living expenses. But trust me, when you have your own space, there is nothing really to compare that to. And no one told me that. You know, it was always the, adulting is going to be difficult and you're going to have challenges, which are true. There are challenges that come with it, but it's actually fun. I think the good far outweighs the bad, because there's just a kind of peace of mind that you get with having your own space and not needing to bother anybody for stuff and having that feeling of independence. And yeah, just the freedom that comes with adulting and having your own space, access to your own space, etc. But let me pull the brakes on this, because while it's true that adulting is fun, you have to also be accountable. Now, the good thing about adulting, you know, tying it to the whole idea of fun, is that nobody can really tell you what to do. But that is also the bad thing, because you have to become more accountable and aware of your expenses. You cannot wake up every day and be going to a movie theater and eating out at fancy restaurants and stuff. You should do that every now and then, but unless you are accountable with your finances and with your time too, because no one is there to come and wake you up. Some of you have your parents come and, it's time to wake up for school and all that. You have to become more accountable, so that if that means setting 100 alarms, if that means committing to going to bed a little bit earlier so that you can wake up a little bit earlier, you have to do those things to keep yourself accountable. I am happy for the experience that I got in my high school years, because back in high school, I used to do school challenge quiz, Bible quiz, and heritage quiz.
What is that? What is that? What is that?
And so for a few months out of the year, I would be boarding on campus with other students. And so we had to learn how to cook, you had to do your laundry and stuff like that. And although we'd study sometimes pretty late into the night, we had to be accountable in that we know that we have school the next morning. And so you can't sleep until midday and miss all your classes. So just that idea of being accountable is something that I wish someone told me, just how important it is to manage your time, manage your resources, and become a lot more responsible, a lot more accountable. Because as I said, nobody is there to wake you up. Nobody is there to tell you do this, do that. Well, unless you reach out and ask somebody to be an accountability partner for you, which is a good idea. If you have someone that you can trust and you want to just say, hey, help me be a lot more accountable with my finances, with my time, and that person can help you in doing such. But I mentioned one of the areas that you need to be accountable is in your finances. Now, I wish someone told me that I should have gotten involved in investing a lot sooner. This is probably one of the bigger mistakes I've made with adulting. I'm kind of just getting started with investing and learning about dividend stocks and all of those good stuff. And one of the persons that I follow very closely, and he gives basically free information. It's not behind a paywall. He just gives awesome information about the stock market, about buying land, about investing. And his name is Demetrius Fairman. Thanks so much, Demetrius, for all the work that you're doing with the stock market and just sharing free education. If you are looking for a place to find really valuable information about the stock market, about buying land, especially as a young person, check out Demetrius's channel on YouTube. But yeah, just learning about investing. There's a lot of stuff to sift through though. Lots of scams are out there, pyramid schemes and people telling you, oh, this is the best way to achieve automated income, automated residual or passive income. Those are just kind of buzzwords and people throw them around, but not many people are really willing to give you the information that you need in order to achieve that. So I wish that I had started learning about investing and even practicing it a lot sooner. Because listen, man, especially since this pandemic hit, I've had to become so much more careful with my finances, and just exploring other ways how to develop other streams of income is really important. So if you are at the stage where you are planning on going off on your own and living somewhere, consider the fact that you need, especially here in Jamaica, you cannot really rely on one stream of income. You need to have at least a few streams of income to even, you know, make ends meet. The fourth thing, and listen, don't judge me, but when I moved here to Montego Bay back in 2017, I allowed myself to buy into the fast food on the weekends culture that is here in Montego Bay. Not a lot of people actually cook on the weekend. I mean, Sundays probably sure, but Fridays and Saturdays. Have you ever seen the line at KFC on a Friday in Montego Bay? Well, I mean, anywhere in Jamaica, because KFC is like, I don't know what the Colonel put in KFC chicken here in Jamaica. But listen, man, as soon as the lights, the KFC lines are full, but especially on weekends. And so I kind of bought into that culture in my early years living here in Montego Bay. So I usually do fast food on a Friday and sometimes a Saturday. And then, you know, I'd cook on Sundays. But listen, man, cook more. I'm serious. Spend more time cooking. And for me, with my health situation and switching up my diet, I've had to become a lot more careful in my whole meal preparation, ensuring that, you know, right amount of calories and just being more aware of all of that stuff. But seriously, spend a lot more time cooking, because going buying fast food, going restaurants every day and stuff like that, it will put you in a bad place financially. I'm not saying that you can't buy fast food, you know, because I have days when we have cheat days. If you're in fitness in any way, you know that you have cheat days, cheat meals. And I know it's a bit of work, and that's one of the things that makes fast food so attractive, but I let you in on a secret. My favorite go-to fast food place is Island Grill. And I mean, I don't really consider Island Grill to be a fast food place per se. But in context, it is. But they have a lot more healthier options than a lot of the other fast food chains. And hey, if anyone from Island Grill is watching it, you know, reach out to me and we can work out something, you know, some sponsorship or anything like that. But anyway, cook more. Seriously, cook more. And then the fifth and final thing is, you get the opportunity to be hospitable. I really enjoy having friends over, and you get to hang out, and you don't have anyone telling that, oh, you know, you need to make the people go to them yard now and all of that stuff. You know how parents can be sometimes, and your friends have to leave, but you know, you can do things like sleepovers. And listen, don't allow any and anybody into your space. Be careful about that. Protect your space. But when you find friends that you can trust, and you know, you meet some really good people along the way, it's fine to be hospitable. You know, for me, sometimes I have my friends over and we play FIFA, we play Mortal Kombat, and we just have a really good time discussing and having fun. And hey guys, we are overdue a link up. My Xbox is there gathering dust. We need to we need to link and have a sleepover or something soon. But yeah, some of these are things that I would have benefited greatly from if I knew them sooner. But others, you know, are just things that are great opportunities to enjoy the experience. So don't be afraid. I know some of you may be at the place where you are thinking about moving out of your parents' house, or you are considering going on your own in one way or the other. Listen, it's an amazing experience. There are many lessons that you're gonna learn and stuff along the way, but I think the good outweighs the bad. So just to recap, adulting is actually fun. There are many things too that are really enjoyable about the experience, but you have to be accountable. You have to be careful about how you spend your time, how you spend your money. Third thing, start investing as soon as you can. So reach out to a financial advisor at Barita, Sajikora, any of those, and get involved in investing. The fourth thing, cook more. And some of you probably can't cook either, you know, but seriously, spend more time in the kitchen preparing meals, and you have a lot more control of what you allow to get into your body that way. And the fifth and final thing is you get the opportunity to be hospitable. You can have friends over, you can have a movie night, a games night, and yeah, just enjoy the experience. So yeah, those are five things that nobody told me about adulting. And if you have some, let me know down in the comments, and let's continue the conversation. I have another video here that dropped recently, so you can check that one out. And I look forward to seeing you in the next one. So happy adulting. See you next time.